Now touch the base with the left foot. Not too wide a turn. Watch out for Rick here. All right, go Oz. Come on, Sam. Oh, Michelle. You all right? Go, Chick, go. Not too wide a turn, you know. All right, catch it. Oh, left talon, left wall, left leg. Left foot.
Come on, chicken.
Go, chicken. Chase, get your chicken. Go. Watch it.
Come on, Freddy. He's catching up.
Come on,
let's go. Left foot. That's what you're doing, Louie. Give me five, Louie. Stay alive. Right on. That's the way to do it. Oh, Chick, you all right? That wasn't too bad, Bunch, but I think we can do better, don't you?
Yeah.
All right, now's a good time maybe we could talk about base running and base stealing, two of baseball's most neglected skills.
What do you know about base stealing?
Have you know, I stole 13 bases one year. Now, I know I'm no ball of fire, but the most important thing in base running is to use your speed to the very best.
Johnny, who is the greatest base stealer of all time?
Well, Michelle, that's a tough one. There have been some great ones through the years.
Ty Cobb played for the Detroit Tigers from 1905 to 1928. And when he retired, he owned almost every base-stealing record, including a grand total of 893 steals. In 1962, Maury Wills of the Los Angeles Dodgers broke Cobb's single-season record by stealing 104 bases. Lou Brock stole 118 bases in 1974 and finished his career with an all-time record 938 stolen bases. Many active players are great base stealers. Chicago White Sox Ron LaFleur. Oakland A's Ricky Henderson, who stole 100 bases in 1980. And Tim Raines, a young superstar stealer from the Expos. But the most successful base stealer ever is Davey Lopes of the Los Angeles Dodgers, who's been safe on more than four out of every five tries.
All right, Bunch, meet Davey
Lopes.
Hello, Bunch. All right, Bunch, Johnny asked me to watch you run the bases. It looks to me like you pretty well know how to run one foot after the other as fast as you can. What I think you need to learn is how to slide. Let's go over to second base where I like to hang out.
Sliding's not an easy thing to do. You should slide only when you have to, when you feel the play is going to be close. There are two reasons for sliding. Number one, you slide to slow down your forward motion. And number two, you slide to avoid the tag. Let me show you what I mean.
Boy, that looked like it hurt.
Sometimes, Michelle, but only when you do it wrong. If you slide on your hip and thigh, you're going to slide on good, firm skin. And the worst you're going to come out with is a little scrape or a strawberry.
Strawberries? I love strawberries!
We noticed that, Sam. We noticed that. We're not talking about those kind of strawberries. A strawberry is nothing more than a scrape or a bruise that looks like a strawberry. The most dangerous thing about sliding is when you're indecisive. When in doubt, slide. It's not dangerous, Michelle, I promise. Let's try it.
Davey, why don't you go ahead with the rest of the bunch? I want to show Michelle something.
Okay, John. Remember when you're sliding, not to slide too close or too far away from the bag.
Where are we going, Johnny?
Well, we're going over here and practice our sliding a little bit.
I don't think I want to slide.
Well, now, Davey was showing you the right way to slide. You're not going to hurt yourself. You know, if you're afraid, now you can face that fear and you can conquer it by doing it. You know, certain things you're going to have to avoid, but I think sliding is the very best way to get into a base. You should never stand up going into a base. You might get hurt. You'll try it for me, won't you?
Okay.
All right, good girl. All right, Michelle, now this is our sliding pit, and we got some nice, deep dirt for you, so no problem. Go to it now. Remember what Davey told you. Come on. Let's see you do it. Now, don't be afraid. It's like you want to go in like a football player and how they sort of fall down to the side. How they extend, legs out, this foot's back. It's kind of going in and just sort of sitting down, okay? Try like that first, all right? Take your time now. Now get down. Going backwards into the base. Come on now, you can do it. I know you can do it. Come on. Get that foot forward. Get that foot in the bag. That's it. That's it. Let me have a look. See? Atta girl, you're extended out here. You got your foot back, all right? Come on, give me another good one. One more try. Now you know you can do it, don't you? Come on, do it for me. One more time. Atta girl, you're safe. Right on. We're going back to see the bunch, all right?
All right.
When I slide, I have my left leg extended towards the bag. Right, chicken. My right knee is bent under my left leg. I slide on my hip and thigh so that when I hit the bag, it slows down my forward motion and I can pop up quickly. Okay? Let me demonstrate what I was just talking about. Here we go.
All right, Coach, I think we're ready. Why don't we try a drill?
Okay, John, but first, Bunch, before we get over to first base, I want you to remember a few of the things that I taught you. Don't slide too close to the bag nor too far. Run straight at the bag, and don't slow down your motion when you come into the bag. Now, Johnny and I are going to judge your slides, so let's see some good hard slides and some nice ones. And the winner is going to get a very good surprise.
Yeah, bonus is our slow-mo instant replay.
All right, let's go to first base. Come on.
How did Michelle do?
She did pretty good, but I think she's still afraid of the strawberries you were talking about.
Well, we got to get rid of that fear element. That's the biggest thing.
I think that's what we got over anyway.
Okay. How about it, Rick? You want to be our first one? Come on, let's go. Give us a good shot. Come on, Rick.
Come on, Rick, now.
Good, very good.
Good
All right.
shot, Rick.
Come on.
Not a way to do it. Come on, let's go.
Come on, Louie. Don't slow down when you go into your slide now. Come on.
Come on, Oz. Get out.
Too late now.
A little bit late. All right, chicken. All right, chicken.
This should be the flight of the moment.
Yeah.
What in the world was that, chicken?
Now let's go. Come on, Kate. A little better than the chicken.
Okay, good slide, but don't go out so far. You want to run in a straight line towards the bag, okay?
All right, come on.
Come on, Harold.
Okay, get that knee bent in a little more. That way
right,
you won't
Sam,
stop
we'll
so quickly.
Okay, Michelle.
Come on now. Hit it. Right, looks pretty good to me.
Come on.
Where'd you learn how to do that?
Come on.
I think we better ask Navy.
I think Michelle's slide deserves another look.
The baseball
bunch. There, I can get that slide down now.
I get this phobia every time I come around second base.
Bunch, Davey Lopes is a great base stealer, as we all can see.
Give me that bag. You never could steal anyhow.
He's a great base stealer, but he's also an all-star second baseman, and he's won the gold glove at that position.
Second base is a very good place to play because you're involved in a lot of action, and you don't have to be very big or strong to play it. The main requirements for a second baseman are coordination and finesse. There have been guys in the big leagues, Louie, not much bigger than you, that have played.
Were you always a second baseman?
No, I started out as an outfielder. I learned to play second base in the minor leagues.
What is the hardest play a second baseman has to make?
That's a loaded question, Louie, because a second baseman has to make many plays. He has to come in on ground balls, go to his left, go to his right, catch pop-ups, catch line drives,
and make it sound as
play.
Hard as catching.
Well, maybe not that hard, John, but don't let anybody fool you. It's a tough position to play. Here's what I mean. Chicken, you're in the wrong place. No, actually, the only time that you're standing on the bag is when you're turning into double play, which is the most important thing that a second baseman has to do. Let's imagine there's one out with a runner on first base, and there's a ground ball hit to the shortstop. When you turn into double play, you run directly towards the bag. Once you get to the bag, simultaneously, you hit the bag with your left foot, and you put your hands up in front of your face with your bare hand close to the glove so that when you reach in, you can take it out very quickly. Once you receive the ball, you push off of your left foot, push back onto your right foot, transfer the weight, throw to first base, and do a little jump, to avoid the runner coming into you.
You know, Davey, there's lots of different kinds of double plays.
That's right, John. I receive throws from the third baseman, and I turn a double play, or I start a double play myself by feeding it to the shortstop.
Well, I was thinking of strikeouts where I throw out a guy trying to steal.
That's right, and I put the tag on the guy, and he's out at second base.
Well, what about when the bases are loaded, and the guy throws it home, and I throw it to first for the double play?
Well, I make a lot of double plays like that myself. On a line drive, hit him, and I just tag the bag.
Well, what about a throw from the outfielder to home plate when I tag him out there? I don't guess you have anything to do with that, do you?
Well, I guess you got me on that one, but you got to admit, second baseman turn a lot of double plays.
Yeah, I do. There are some original double plays, and let's look at some of them right now.
I can have a dream, baby. Who can make that dream?
You're really going to get a chance to see how it feels to turn a double play. We got Ricky at shortstop, and we got Johnny over at first base. So, Harold, why don't you be first up and turn in a double play? Come on, let's go. Let's do it right now.
Come on, Harold!
Okay, the first thing you got to do, remember, is catch the ball. That's the most important thing. And hit the bag with your left foot up like this here, okay? And then push off and throw to first base. All right? Try it again. Okay, push off, throw. That's pretty good.
That's it. Got two.
Okay, let's go. Who's next? Come on, Ozzy. Run to the bag. Run to the bag. Push you off and throw. Okay, that's a good one. Real good one. Who's next? Come on, chicken. Show them how to do it. The chicken. Come on. Let's go. Come on. What in the world is that, chicken? Come on, now you got a good demonstration for these kids. Come on, Kate. Come on. Here we go.
Come on, Kate.
Come on, Rick. That's it. Hit it with your left foot. Pivot. All right. Okay, that was a real good one. Who's next? Louie, it's your turn. All right, let's give it a try. Huh, Louie? Push off. Hey, that's pretty good. All right. Now you're really going to see what it's like to have a guy come running at you and trying to knock you into center field somewhere. We're going to have the chicken go down to first base, and he's going to slide in here. See if you can pass the sliding chicken test. Don't be afraid. Now, when he gets a little close to you, throw the ball and just jump a little bit, okay? Okay, Rick, let's give him a good toss. Come on, Louie, come on. Hit it out. Throw it. All right. Here we go. Let's hear it from Louie. Okay. He's out. Chicken is out. All right, way to go, Lou, way to go. All right,
Bunch, let's see how much you know about baseball. Sam, let's say you're the hitter, and you're at the plate, and you get hit by a pitch. What would happen?
I get to go to first.
How do you know that?
Everybody knows that. It's a rule.
That's right, it's a rule. Baseball is a game of rules. Over 100 pages of rules.
I hate rules. I just want to win.
Well, Rick, you don't win unless you play by the rules. Baseball wouldn't be any fun if people didn't play by the same rules.
And besides, if there weren't any rules, how would anybody know what to do?
Right. The reason you get 4 balls and 3 strikes is because it says so right here in the rule book. And the rule book tells you all other kinds of interesting things. How big the field should be, what size glove or bat you could use, and also what happens when a player does something wrong. Rick, let's say you hit a long fly over the chicken's head. He throws his glove up, knocks the ball down, comes in and tags you out. What would happen?
You're not out. That's cheating.
Right. It's against the rules. You'd be safe.
It says that in there.
Yep.
Hey, I like these rules.
Right. Let's play a little game. Pretend you're the umpire. Watch the magic board carefully and make your call.
The Atlanta Braves have runners on second and first base. the batter hits a hard single to left field, which gets the runner in motion. A strong throw from the outfield is cut off by the infielder. The two runners are trapped at third base and both get tagged. Confused? Check the rule.
Rule 703 on page 54 of the official baseball rules say two runners may not occupy a base, but if while the ball is alive, two runners are touching a base, the following runner shall be out when tagged. The preceding runner is entitled to the base.
What does that mean?
Yeah.
Well, the key right there, Freddie, is the following runner shall be out when tagged. In other words, if you're the lead runner, if you've already got to that base, then you're entitled to that base. The guy running behind you cannot come there. He has to go back before he is tagged out. So let's play again. Let's do something with Michelle. Michelle, you be the umpire and you make the call.
Sure, Johnny.
It's the 1976 World Series and there's a runner on first base. A ground ball is hit to the second baseman who tries to tag the runner but misses. All the same, the umpire calls him out.
Does anybody know why he's out? Louie.
He left the base path.
That's right. Rule 708 says any runner is out when he runs more than 3 feet away from a direct line between bases to avoid being tagged. So what happens is that there's a line between the two bases. And you can run 3 feet on either side of that, and you're safe. But you cannot be there running all over the field and doing all those silly things. We'd be there all day chasing. Have you met chasing the chicken that far? All right, let's put the professor on the spot.
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right. Mr. Professor here.
It's the 1978 World Series. With runners on first and second, a line drive is dropped, and throw to first hits the runner, Reggie Jackson. What's your call, Harold?
Well, I know that the runner's not out if he gets hit by a thrown ball, so I guess to just let the play stand.
Well, Rule 709F says it is interference by a batter or a runner when any batter or runner who has been just put out hinders or impedes any following play being made on a runner.
I don't get it. What's that mean?
Yeah, I don't know.
Well, it means, Sam, that you can't let the ball hit you on purpose, basically. Let's watch it again.
Dodger shortstop Bill Russell drops the line drive. But Reggie Jackson, the runner on first, doesn't know which way to go. Russell's throw to first hits Reggie. Now, did Reggie let it hit him on purpose? That's what the Dodger manager thought.
That the runner didn't do it on purpose. So you can see how hard it is to be an umpire. But if we didn't have umpires to decide the rules, they'd probably still be out there arguing. Isn't that right, old Dugout Wizard?
Oh, yes. You caught me off guard. I was watching that manager. Well, the lesson for today obviously is be alert. Every position on the field requires a player's total awareness, whether you're at the plate, running the bases, or in the field. You have to know the score, how many outs there are, what the count on the batter is, and who's on base. Think ahead and be alert. Nothing is worse than making a mental mistake. There's no excuse for it. Here's what I mean. Those are the plays that can drive a manager crazy. Now, don't get me wrong. Errors are part of the game. A physical error when a player is trying is one thing. A mental error means that the player just fell asleep on the job and let himself and his teammates down. All you have to do is to be alert. There's nothing quite so rewarding as good heads-up baseball. Watch. The way to do it. Oh, if only all the dugout wizards of the world could somehow convince their players that this is the way to play. What a wonderful world it would be. So, Bunch, play heads-up baseball, and don't forget the magic words, be alert.
Okay, Bunch, sound advice again from the dugout wizard. What did you learn about sliding today, Michelle?
That it doesn't hurt to slide on your hip or thigh and not to be afraid.
That's right. Also, only slide when you have to and try to slide away from the throw. What about playing second base, Rick?
Well, when you get a throw on a double play, you're supposed to make sure you get one out before you get two.
Yeah, and after you throw the ball to first, make sure you get out of the way of the runner.
Yeah.
Hey, Bunch, let's let our friend hear the dugout wizard's message for today. One, two, three.
Be alert!
Let's go play ball.